The best way to describe like why I change my sense and stuff too is like sometimes I'll be doing well on a sensitivity, but then I'll be like struggling in like one aspect. So like I'm fulfilling different roles. So on defense, I do actually like playing lower sensitivities. On attack, I will like playing higher sensitivities. It's to make my life easier and to make sure I don't get like tired out.
So what does this mean? Is it better to change your sensitivity often? What about your other settings? What about consistency? Then I asked, can changing your sensitivity improve your aim? I needed answers, so naturally I went to Reddit. And to my surprise, I found a post under the Counter-Strike subreddit dated 3 years ago, titled, "Science Says You Should Change Your Sensitivity," posted by user Zotek. In it, I found attached a link to a research paper published by the NIH. So researchers from the Johns Hopkins and the Kennedy Krieger Medical Institution came together in 2016 to delve into how muscle memory could be developed effectively and how motor skills could be improved through reconsolidation. What's reconsolidation? Well, consolidation is a process of making something stronger or more solid. Therefore, reconsolidation is the act or process of consolidating something again or in a different way. So, how does that have anything to do with improving your aim? Well, here's how the argument goes. Rather than staying on the same sensitivity forever, by changing it frequently, it forces your body to adapt to the new change. That requires focus, and that in turn can boost performance. It's like having to relearn how to control your mouse, but your body is already very familiar with the movement. You end up reactivating the same neural pathways, and you're able to strengthen your muscle memory in new and different ways. In fact, what's interesting was that the experiments conducted by the researchers were similar to what we're dealing with. They had participants use a mouse to aim and click on targets presented on the screen. Except some of us are probably better at using the mouse than others, so to eliminate that variable, the researchers provided the subjects with a different kind of mouse. Rather than having to move it physically, to move the cursor up or down, the subjects had to squeeze the sides of the mouse. This placed everyone more or less at the same level. Here's how the experiments went. They separated the participants into groups and instructed them to click on the targets as fast as possible. That was test 1. Then they moved on to a practice session where they were able to get used to the controls more before moving on to test 2. Here's where it gets interesting. The researchers changed the sensitivity for some participants without telling them during the practice session to see how they would perform in the final test. The results, to put it simply, showed that those who had their sensitivities changed during the practice session saw a significant improvement in performance compared to those who had the same sense the whole time. However, using the same sensitivity for test 1, practice 1, but then changing sense for test 2 showed greatly reduced performance. The same goes for changing the sensitivity after the first test and then leaving it unchanged. So what does this mean? It showed that, yeah, to an extent, adjusting your sense forces your brain to activate more thoroughly to adapt to the change, which can boost performance. I think that perhaps it's our brains being lazy, and if there's nothing new about a situation, we begin to reduce the amount of resources we allocate into performing that task. But when change is introduced, our brain has to focus more to figure out what's different, and that requires more resources. But ultimately, that's all on paper. What do the pros have to say about it? Unfortunately, I tried reaching out to professional Valorant players to get their opinions on this, but as expected, I didn't get a response. Thankfully, last year, Betway Esports released a video where they interviewed 8 professional Counter-Strike players where they asked them how often do they change their settings, which I thought would provide some great insight as to what they think. Out of the 8 pros featured in the interview, 7 preferred having the same consistent settings rather than changing it up. Threat was the only one who, well,
I don't even know what settings I have.
So that's what the pros say. Well, what do other people think? I went a little closer to home and I asked my friends who were used to FPS games for their opinions on consistency versus variation. Out of those who responded, all of them told me that they preferred having the same consistent settings as they thought that changing your sense is more of a mental thing. I wanted to see for myself how changing my sense could be beneficial, so I took it upon myself to see if I saw any significant changes to my performance in-game. For the record, I have always played on 1600 DPI and with 0.24 sens. But in the past month, I've decided to adjust it by a margin of 0.5, meaning that I've played as low as 0.19 and as high as 0.29, and I adjusted it pretty frequently, even going back to my normal sense occasionally. I played like that for a month in Valorant.
Jump down more.
screens.
Yeah, go for it.
She's in. And after a month of frequent adjustments to my sense, I found that there was little to no change in my performance. I maintained the same rank all throughout in the last episode's Act 3 as Immortal, deviating only by one or two ranks. When Episode 5 hit, I placed Ascendant, and I am back now in Immortal 1. I feel like my aim hasn't improved or worsened, and my KD has stayed pretty much the same.
Yellow.
I admit that it did make me focus more on how I shoot, since my new sensitivity always threw me off from what I was used to, but it didn't take long to adapt. So, after everything we covered today, the research, the experiments, the interviews, I guess what it all means is that it's up to you.